Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we have a negative 2 over 3. Let me just rewrite that question down right here. Subtract a negative 5 over 6, okay? Before we take to the next step, I want you to see that there's a negative and a negative. So it means positive, okay? So let's just rewrite that down here, make it into a positive, makes the question look a little bit simpler. Then, you know you're dealing with fractions, right? You got a numerator and a denominator. So if you're going to put them together, it has to have a common denominator. So what's the common denominator between the 3 and 6? It has to be the lowest one, right? So I'm just going to bring the work over here. I'm going to retry it one more time. So my common denominator is going to be 6 for both of them, okay? So the 3 over here times by 2 to the top and bottom. So the work for here is this. I need to times this number by a 2, times that number by a 2 up top. So what I got is this. If that's 3 times 2 is 6, then the 2 times 2 is negative 4, because there's a negative in the front of that. So 2 times 2 is 4, there's also negative. The 5 and 6 kind of stays the same, because technically you times this by 1, you times that by 1. So what happened is you get yourself still the 5 from before. So that part stays the same, okay? So your final answer for this question turns out to be, again, keep the denominator the same, don't change your denominator, but you will take the negative 4, add a 5, and that leaves you just a 1. So there is your final answer, which is 1 over 6. Okay, thanks for watching.